Well, good morning. What's up, y'all? Welcome to your Tuesday morning. Flow 2, I'm Randy. Good to be here today. Hoping to see some people jump into this bad boy. And we'll have some fun here shortly. I see one eye. Can I get a sound check from who do I got? Oh, I like it. I like it. The numbers, they're growing. This is the kind of infection I'm looking for here, y'all. Keep them coming. Keep them coming. Good to see you. Nice, nice. How's the sound? You guys hear me okay? About 6:58 right now. We'll get started here in just a few minutes. I mean, feel free to hit me with how you're doing. Yes, what's up, big bro? Good to see you, man. My own boy Mark is in the house, dude. You're gonna dig this morning, man. You'd be able to do this with your blindfold on, dude. So cool. Well, what you're fortunate enough to be joining me from the lovely office, which is Center Copy Printing, my sweet little wonderful, amazing 3.5-year-old Isla. I don't know that she's going to give me space this morning to practice, so I figured I'd change plans and head up to town and get this out of the way before another workday. You know. I know it's tough out there for everyone right now, trying to figure out how to best spend your time. Grateful that you're going to share it with me. We'll get started here in just a couple of minutes. We've got eyes on right now, so everybody can hear me. Cool. I hope I'll kind of roll with my beginning here. And today, you know, when I first learned professionally how to teach yoga. I was taught a specific sequence, and I'm going to actually rock through that sequence for you today. Now, the postures themselves are not terribly advanced, so for all my yogis out there, I know that you're all at different levels, and that's the beauty of this. Wherever it is that you are right now with your practice is the right place for you to be, and your opportunity today is to either explore poses more deeply. You know, we may spend a little more time in postures, move a little slower, but there's going to be plenty of opportunity for you to up level as well. So I'm going to leave that to you to decide. You know, sometimes it's when things are most simple, which is the real practice in terms of being able to control our thoughts. Being able to channel love and keep distraction, keep fear and anger and hate and any of those negative feelings from taking over. But I think this is an opportunity where we can practice together to use our breath to help bring presence back into this space. We're going to go ahead and get started. Can somebody ping me and let me know that you can hear me okay? I do see some eyes in, but I want to just certainly make sure sound's working. I'm going to rock some jams. I hope this works out. Sometimes Facebook can get a little quirky, but hopefully this playlist will come through and resonate. I played around with the sound. I think it's going to translate. We'll get started here in another 60 seconds. Again, grateful for you to be sharing this time with me today. Hey, Cody. I'll miss you, homegirl. How are you? Say what's up, D. Wood. I can see you're in the house. How you doing, brother? Right on. Okay. So we're going to get started in child's pose today. I'm going to be mirroring you guys. So, like, I'm going to be working left when you're working right, when I'm cueing right. So, you know, I'm getting more and more practice on working with this type of instruction. Let me know, at least after the fact, maybe. I probably won't be able to see your comments along the way. But we'll get started in child's pose today. So go ahead and find your mat. Spread your knees out wide and bring your big toes to touch. Rest your forehead down and sit back on your heels. Now, for those of you with low back, maybe knee trouble, it's okay to stay up high. It's okay just to simply work at whatever capacity you can. Your goal to rest your third eye all the way down and start to activate your practice. Now it's Ujjayi breath, Ujjayi pranayama that you are working towards here. So you're still in your child's pose. I'm just the instructor up here wanting to make sure that, yes, nice, nice. Love to have you all with us today. Your inhale breath is going to bring that which you want to manifest in your world to you. Your exhale breath is simply there to let go of any obstacles that are in your way. So, that being said, as you work your way through this practice and you struggle or you find yourself in a position where your mind is elsewhere, somewhere different than your mat, plenty of opportunity for that to find us in today's circumstance. Simply take note, what was it maybe? What was it that brought you away from being present here in the moment? And it's definitely okay. Just remember that you can always tap right back into your breath to help bring you back to presence in this moment. Whatever your day had in front of you, whatever your day was going to be made up of, it's going to be right there for you when we finish up here in about 60 minutes. So with that being said, we'll take a couple more rounds of breath. Thanks, Mylise. Miss you. Sunday was so much fun. Or was that Saturday? That was Saturday, that call. Anyway, right on, y'all. Here we go. I'm going to cue up some music, and let's get started. So we're in child's pose. Again, your breath to explore yourself from the inside out. Pull your shoulder blades back into socket. Spread your fingertips out wide. Maybe start to activate your arms, clawing, alternating side to side with your hands. So that Ujjayi breath helps keep you present in this moment, but it also helps build heat from within. It's elevating temperature, core temperature, which helps decrease your chance of injury, increase your body's ability to move. And if you need to take some movement to free up space, that's quite all right. Please do. Good. One more deep breath in. Exhale, let it go. Then inhale, come forward to all fours and take some organic movement. Could be circles at your shoulders and hips. Maybe they're cat-cows. Good. Find stillness in tabletop pose. Stack your shoulders over your wrists, your hips over your knees. Deep breath in, cow pose. Let your stomach drop. Shift your gaze up high. Exhale, breath, exhale, cow, cat pose, let it go. Inhale, flow with your breath. And exhale, return. Breath in. Cat pose. One more round. And then settle back to tabletop. Curl your toes underneath. Send your hips high for downward facing dog. Walk it out. Shift your hips from side to side. Ground down through all 10 fingers and all 10 toes. Notice when I bend my knees, I can send my hips up a little higher. Settle your heels down a little bit closer to the mat. Good. Let everything settle to stillness. 3 rounds of breath. Good. One more deep breath in. Exhale, let it go. Inhale, look to the top of your space. And then exhale, travel forward, ragdoll forward fold. Bring feet hip-width distance apart. Hands to opposite elbow creases and let your head hang heavy. The option is sway from side to side. But you can bend your knees a lot here. Bend them so much your belly button comes all the way to your thighs. Good. One more breath in. And exhale, release your hands down. Heel toe your toes to touch. One breath, one vertebra at a time. Inhale, slowly unwind. For Samasthiti, palms in heart center. Elbows wide. Good. Now stand up tall. Pull your hips underneath you. Lift your heart up a little bit higher. Your knees spiral open to plug your femurs into your hips. Grow tall. Good. One more breath to seal it in. And then exhale, release your hands down. Inhale, arms up high. Mountain pose. Good. Spiral your pinkies inward here. Soften the grip with your toes to ground down through the four corners of your feet. Ride your inhale breath just beyond your fingertips. Good. And then exhale, forward fold. We'll take 3 rolling halfway lifts. Breath in. Leverage your heart forward. Exhale, fold deep. Inhale, brings length. Keep your gaze neutral. Exhale, fold. Halfway lift. Now plant your hands, lower yourself all the way down to the mat. Elbows hug in, squeeze your ribs. 3 rolling cobras. Inhale. Exhale, lower down. Nice. Now press your feet down so much so your knees lift. Inhale, breath for length. Exhale, lower down. Cobra pose, little to no weight, maybe your hands lift, and exhale, return through tabletop or high plank, inhale, to downward facing dog. Now we'll flow twice, one breath to one movement here. Inhale, look forward to your hands, exhale, hop, step, or float to the top. Halfway lift for length, exhale, fold deep. Mountain pose, rise up. Exhale, forward fold. Halfway lift, one time. Chaturanga, high to low. Now you've got options. You can step or float back. Elbows in if you land. Bent elbows. Inhale, cobra or upward facing dog. Exhale, back for downward facing dog. One more round. Inhale, look to your hands. Exhale, travel forward. Halfway lift. Fold deep. Mountain pose, rise up. Exhale, dive forward. Halfway for length. Chaturanga, high to low. Inhale up. To downward facing dog. Moving on. Send your right leg high. Now work here. Extend your right leg as long as you can. Now press up and out of your right left hip to send your right leg a little higher. Deep breath in. Exhale, step through low lunge. Couple breaths here from your lunge.
Notice your right knee is stacked right over your right ankle. Your left leg is strong and extended to the wall behind you. Couple rounds of breath. Think train tracks for the width of your legs. You're not on a tightrope. One more breath out. Inhale, rise up to warrior two. Spiral your left heel down. Keep your right knee stacked over your right ankle. Bring your arms to shoulder height and reach away from one another. Now maybe a little self-adjust. Broaden across the hips. Zip up your midline. Pull length towards the sky. Breath in. Exhale, extended side angle. Reach, reach, reach your right arm forward and bring your right elbow inside your right knee. Now send your left arm long. You've got one line of energy from the outside edge of your left foot beyond your fingertips. Each exhale breath, the chance to leverage your heart towards the sky. One more breath out. Inhale, reverse warrior. Bring your left hand to your left thigh. Shine your right palm to the wall behind you. Exhale, deepen forward into your lunge. And then each breath, open up space on your right side. One more breath in. Exhale, chaturanga, high to low. Cartwheel your arms down. Step back to high plank. Option to ekapada your right foot. Inhale, cobra or upward facing dog. Exhale, back to downward facing dog. Second side, you'll see me from the back this time. Inhale, send your left leg high. Hold here. Explore this pose here. Try and keep downward facing dog in your arms. Up and out of your right hip to extend your left leg a little higher. Deep breath in. And exhale, step through. Low lunge. Now again, find your feet. Soft grip with your toes on your left front foot. Left knee stacked over your left ankle, 90 degrees. One more deep breath out. Inhale, rise up for warrior two. Good. This time your right foot, the knife's edge of your right foot down. Now scissor your inner leg line together. Pull length in your spine. Stand up just a little bit taller. And then soften your shoulders down your back. One more breath in. Exhale, extended side angle. Again, one line of energy. Scissor your inner legs together and leverage your twist up towards the sky. Good. One more breath out. Inhale, reverse. Good. And then settle in. Each breath, pull your hips to the wall behind you. But find something new with each breath. One more for length. Exhale, cartwheel down, chaturanga, high to low. Inhale up, exhale back for downward facing dog. Walk it out. Nice job, couple rounds of breath. We'll flow twice, simple sun V, one breath to one movement. Good, find stillness in your downward facing dog. Spiral your shoulders down your back as you root deeper into the earth beneath you. Inhale, send your left leg high, right leg rather. Slow lunge, step through. Breath in, rise up. Warrior two. Exhale, extended side angle. Inhale, reverse warrior. Exhale, chaturanga, high to low. Inhale up. Now you've got options. You can add push-ups to downward facing dog, left leg high, low lunge, step through. Warrior two, rise up, extended side angle. Inhale, reverse. Exhale, ride your breath down. Option to add push-ups. Ekapada is the single leg variety. We'll meet back in downward facing dog. Three breaths. So strong, yogis. Stay with me. Inhale, send your right leg high. Exhale, low lunge, step through. Warrior two, rise up. Open up. Extended side angle. Inhale, reverse warrior. Ride your breath down. Inhale, upward facing dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. Left leg high. Low lunge. Warrior two. Extended side angle. Inhale, reverse. Exhale, cartwheel down. High or low. Inhale up. To downward facing dog. Nice work. Drop your knees. Swivel around to a seat for a little belly up core.
How we doing? I got any feedback? I gotta yell. Yeah, well, I see no complaints at the moment, so I love you all. Let's fire up the core. Here we go.
Supta Baddha Konasana sit-ups. Soles of your feet together, your knees hang open. Hands behind your head. Exhale, lift. Inhale, lower. Shh. Open mouth, exhale here, releases heat. If you want to up level, you can lift your feet up off the ground. Wherever you are, press your feet together as hard as you can. You got this, yogi, stay with me. We'll pulse in 8, 7, six. For three. Two. Hold high. And pulse. Four. Three. Two. One. Bicycle sit up. Stack your knees over your hips. Exhale. Twist. Twist. Up level here. Scissor your legs. Now each rep, work to get both shoulder blades off the mat. If they don't go there, it's okay as long as you keep trying for them to. Breathe. Now try not to bring your knees past your hips. For an added sensation. And that's what we're after, yogis. You've got 8, 4, 3, 2, 1, full body stretch. Arms overhead, legs out long, deep breath in. Exhale, let it go. Good. Bring your hands next to your hips. Send your legs up the wall. We'll hip thrust. Here we go. Lift. Lower. Now pull your toes back towards your face. Now this action is smaller than you would think. Keep your low back down. Squeeze your legs together. Lift. Lower. Lift. Breathe. You've got 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, we'll corkscrew, 3, 2, and side, side, side. It's a pulse with a little oblique. Turn, turn, 8, 7, 6, 4, 3, 2, hug your knees in, maybe massage out your low back. Now we'll rock and roll here. We're not quite done with core just yet, but sit up to boat pose. So if you can, feet can be down, or you can lift your feet up off the mat. Now ground your sits bones down to lift your heart up just a little higher. Option to extend your legs, lower down, part way, and then exhale, sit back up, squeeze. Inhale, open. Exhale, sit up. One more. Again, exhale. Nice work. Breathe. Cross your ankles. Plant your palms. And find high plank. Good. Inhale, hinge forward, lower down. And we'll stretch your stomach out just a little bit here. Good, a little up dog, maybe look left, maybe look right. And meet me back in downward facing dog. How are we doing? So I'm gonna pivot, I'm gonna face the camera now. From downward facing dog, inhale, look forward to your hands. And exhale, travel forward to the top. Halfway lift for length. Fold deep. First time, chair pose, sit low. Good. Spiral your pinkies inward here. Now from the side, chair pose, send your hips to the wall behind you, but still lift your heart. Good. Scissor your knees in. Squeeze everything to center your midline. So now that you've got this from the side, stay facing me. So strong with your breath, yogis. Deep breath in for length. And then exhale, bring your palms through to heart center. Inhale, fill up. Exhale, prayer twist to your right. So bring your left elbow outside your right knee. And then notice your left hip wants to bump forward. Pull it back in line. Take your gaze where you're trying to go. And then sit a little deeper because you are strong. Now, I know I've got some yogis with side crow in their practice. Okay, for you to go there now. I'm going to stay put. Your goal here, no matter how small the difference, is to find something new with each breath. And if you can keep your hips below your heart, and your heart below your head, that's the goal. Good. One more. If your side crow, start to make your way back. Good. One more breath in for length. Exhale, forward fold. Let it go. So heel toe your feet hip width distance. Use your peace fingers to grab your big toe. We'll leverage a forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift. And then exhale, your elbows track out wide. Again with your breath, inhale, pull, lengthen. Exhale, surrender. One more here, fill up. Find length, send your hips back. And then exhale, hold flow here. Bend to your knees to support your low back. In fact, bend them so much your belly button comes all the way to your thighs. Good. One more breath in for length. Exhale, surrender, depth. Release your hands one at a time. Heel toe your big toes to touch. Reset, a halfway lift. Breath in. exhale, forward fold. Second side, chair pose, sit low. So this time we'll go opposite. Deep breath in, and then exhale, we'll take it to the left. Your right elbow outside your left thigh. Again, square your hips. Keep them in line with your shoulders. Soften your left shoulder blade down your back. Press your palms into one another to bring your sternum around in line. Again, if you took side crow on the other side, feel free to take it now. If you want to see a side crow, bend your knees, let them track forward, out in front. Shift your hands down outside your left side. Good, keep your eyes in front of your fingertips, and then extend your leg. Now, scissor your elbows in. Eyes forward keeps you from toppling over. Side crows make your way back. Good, one more breath in, and then exhale, forward fold. Again, heel toe out wide, we'll take gorilla pose. Palms of your hands, slide them underneath your feet. Deep breaths. Good, one more breath in. Good, and then release your hands one at a time. We'll sit low into frog squat. That's okay if your heels, like mine do, lift up off the mat. You can always work them down towards the mat. If you've got them all the way down, that's cool as well. But we'll find full crow here. Release your hands, shoulder width distance. Stand up tall with your legs and bring your knees to your triceps. Keep your gaze out in front. Maybe lift one foot. Maybe lift the other. And for full crow, both feet up off the mat. Good. One more breath in. And then exhale. You can step or shoot your legs back. Chaturanga. Inhale, upward facing dog. Exhale back, downward facing dog. Nice work. All right. For this next round, I'm going to face forward. Inhale, send your right leg high. Exhale, low lunge. Step through. Crescent lunge, rise up. So crescent lunge, both feet are square forward. Send your arms up high, deepen forward into your lunge. From the side, stay put. Straight line here. If you've got low back and need to soften in, totally cool. From the front, hip width distance, deep breath in. Exhale, hands through heart center. Inhale, hinge forward. And then we'll take revolve crescent lunge to the right. Similar to your prayer twist. Now, if you need a modification, you can always drop your left back knee down. For an added challenge, bump your left hip up just a little bit higher. Something new with each breath, yogis. You got this. Good. One more deep breath in for length. And then exhale, runner's lunge is your release. Hands inside your right leg. Heel toe your right foot out a little bit wider. Drop your left knee down. And then maybe just take a little time to move. Open up your right hip. For those of you that can work down to your elbows, you know where to go. Thank you. quad stretch is another place you can go. Reaching back with your right hand for your left ankle. So flex your toes on your right foot to protect your right knee. Good. If you're down on your elbows or if you've got the bind, start to make your way back. Good. Extend your left leg back and bring your right leg back to meet your left for high plank. Deep breath in. Inhale. Open up to your right side plank. Shift your gaze high. Now you can always drop your bottom knee to lift a little bit higher. There's a bind variation here for Trapasana. If you want it, you can take it. If you want to add on, the top leg lift is also an option. 4, 3. Option to chaturanga or skip. Left hand down and flow. We'll meet in downward facing dog. Nice job. Second side, send your left leg high. And then step through. Low lunge. I'm going to pivot here. Crescent lunge, rise up. Deepen forward if you can. Find 90 degrees in your front knee. Now hug your ribs in here. Engage your core. Still pull length in your spine. Deep breath in. Exhale, hands through heart center. Inhale, hinge forward. And then revolve crescent lunge to the left. How's your breath? Stay strong in your back leg, or remember, you've got the variation of dropping your back knee down. Up level again, stay high, maybe even grow your branches. One more for length, and then exhale, release. Plant your palms down for runner's lunge on the second side. Again, maybe roll to the outside edge of your left foot. What can you surrender here? If you took the bind on the other side with the quad stretch variation, or made your way to your elbows, honor whatever you had done on the other side. Good. Variations start to make your way back. Again, this time, extend your left leg back to meet your right. Roll to your left side plank. From the side, let me step. Your variations, knee can be down. Or a top leg lift for an added challenge. But wherever you are, lift up and out of your left shoulder. Shine your fingertips bright. Good, one more breath in. Exhale, option, chaturanga, high to low. Inhale up to downward facing dog, nice job. Inhale, walk your hands back to meet your feet. Heel toe your big toes to touch, one at a time. Inhale, breath, unwind. Nice. Great job, yogis. Let's get a little balance pose. So chair pose, sit low. We'll take eagle, left elbow, right elbow under left. Sit low into your chair, bring your right leg up and over. Send your hips back, sit a little deeper. Now squeeze everything in. You can always kickstand your toes. You can go for a double bind. I'm getting closer. Now lift your elbows to shoulder height as you sit your hips a little bit deeper. So strong, yogis. Center your drishti. Find one point of focus. One more deep breath out. Inhale, staff pose, stand tall. And then exhale to dancers. Reach your right arm back for your right ankle. Inhale, reach a little bit higher, grow a little taller. And then exhale, you can start to kick. Totally okay and expected to fall down. It's never that we fell, only how we get back up. Again, one more breath out, and then inhale. Find your way back to standing. Nice, release your arms down. How we doing? We'll switch sides, chair pose, breath in. Let's go left elbow under right, sit low, and then bring your left leg up and over. Now, a little trick here. The deeper your hips are, the closer they are to the ground, the lower your center of gravity, the easier the balance. Now soften the grip with your toes on your right foot. Sit a little deeper, square your hips a little straighter. And then everything in, it's a watertight seal in between your legs. You give yourself a hug, you know you've been missing them. Good, one more deep breath out. Inhale, rise up, staff pose. Exhale, dancers to the other side. Reach for the inside edge of your left foot. Inhale, each inhale pulls your heart up, lifts you up and out of your right hip, and each exhale, kick back. Now square your left hip down towards the mat, in line with your shoulders. This is a little bit of a back bend. It's okay, draw your tailbone away to support your low back. Good, one more for length. Good, exhale, let it go, come on back up. So strong, yogis, palms at heart center. Close your eyes or shift your gaze down. What comes up here for you? Nice job. Breath in to seal it in. And then exhale, release your hands down. Inhale, arms up high. Exhale, forward fold. Halfway lift for length. Chaturanga high to low. Plant your hand, step or float back. Inhale up. And exhale back. Downward facing dog. Send your right leg high. One more standing series here. Low lunge, step through. Inhale, rise up. Warrior one. So maybe narrow your stance. Spread your feet a little wider. And then work towards squaring your hips forward. Back leg is like a kickstand, driving your left hip forward. Pull your right hip back so they're square. Each breath, again, a chance to lengthen a little bit further. One more fill up. And then exhale, open up to warrior two. Reverse triangle, extend your front leg, Shine your right palm to the wall behind you. Exhale, triangle pose. Pull your hips out from underneath you. Reach, reach, reach. And then bring your hands to 12 and 6. Now it's okay, little to no weight in your hand that's down, but it can leverage your heart towards the sky. Soften your left shoulder down your back. Soften the grip of the toes on your right front foot. Good, one more breath in. And then exhale, let it go. Inhale, engage your core, rise all the way up to standing. Pivot your feet. Deep breath in, reach high. Exhale, wide leg, forward fold. So from the side, soft bend to your knees if you need them. Weight shifts forward into the balls of your feet. Your breath, each one, a chance to find something new. Ground down through the outside edges of your feet. Good, one more breath in. Good, inhale, halfway lift. Exhale your arms out to a T. With a long, flat spine, rise up. And then exhale, warrior two. Inhale, reverse. Exhale, cartwheel down. Inhale, up. Exhale, back. Second side, left leg high. Step through, low lunge. Warrior one. Spiral your right heel down. Now this time, don't be surprised if your sides feel a little different. Still working to square your right hip forward, pull your left hip back. Now stay grounded through the outside edge of your back foot. One more breath in for length. And then exhale, open up for warrior two. Inhale, reverse triangle. And exhale, triangle pose. Reach, reach, reach. And fold. Stay strong in your front leg. Option for a half bind here. Maybe even the full expression, the full bind. If it's in your practice, you know where to go. Good, one more breath for length. Exhale, shift your gaze down with strength in your core. Inhale, rise up, five-pointed star. I'll pivot this time, release your hands behind your back, breath in. Exhale, wide leg, forward fold with chest expansion. Soften your shoulder blades together as you lift your hands up off your back. Let your head hang heavy here. Shift weight into the balls of your feet just like side one. Good, one more breath in. And then exhale, release your hands down. Halfway lift for length. Arms out to a T. Inhale, rise up with a strong core. And exhale, warrior two to the front. Breath in, reverse, exhale, cartwheel down. Inhale up to downward facing dog. Nice work. So we'll spine strengthen from here. As always, take water if you need it. Inhale, hinge forward. And then exhale, lower down. Press the tops of your feet down for cobra pose. Inhale, lift your heart with your knees. Little to no weight in your hands. Keep your gaze neutral. Each breath, a chance to lift just a little bit higher. Good. Soften your glutes. For 3, 2, 1, lower down. Maybe shift your gaze to the right, arms to your side, palms up. You can always windshield wiper your legs to release your low back. Good. Second side. Inhale your chin back to center, floor bow. Reach for both ankles. Scissor everything in first. Ground your hips down. Inhale, lift your heart, kick your legs. Now soften your shoulder blades together. Now a simple quad stretch staying down on the mat is totally acceptable. But if you can kick a little bit higher to drive the pose, please do. Good, keep your gaze neutral. One more breath in for length. And then exhale, shift your gaze right. Good, inhale, back to center. Bring your hands under your shoulders. Walk yourself back into standing on your knees for camel pose. This is a back bend here, a heart opener. Bring your hands to your back pockets. Keep your hips underneath your shoulders and bring them forward. Keep them stacked over your knees. Inhale, lift your heart. Shift your gaze up. Exhale, start to trace a line on the ceiling towards the wall behind you. Now, don't go further back if you didn't lift up with your inhale breath. Good. Scissor your inner leg line together. Now, if reaching for your heels is in your practice, you can do that. Each breath, find something new. Good. And then inhale slowly. Make your way out. Sit back on your heels. Bring both hands to your heart. And close your eyes. Gently flutter your eyes open. Release your hands outside your hips. Forward to tabletop pose. To downward facing dog. Send your hips up. Inhale. Send your right leg high. Half pigeon. Pull your right knee outside your right wrist. I'll pivot forward. Extend your left leg to the wall behind you. Now maybe play around a little bit with the lift. Ground down with your right leg. Flex your right toes. Open up space in your left hip flexor, your left psoas. And when you're ready, exhale, breath, walk it forward to sleeping pigeon. Each breath here, a chance to find something new. Good. With your next inhale, start to lock yourself back in. Plant your palms underneath your shoulders and send your right leg high. Shake it out, maybe open it up, and if you've got Wild Thing or Flip Dog in your practice and you want to take it, by all means. One more breath in. Exhale, return. We'll switch it out, send your left leg high, and then half pigeon, left knee outside your left wrist. So keep your hips and shoulders square in one line. Maybe you take the extension to open up, to activate. And when you're ready, walk forward to sleeping pigeon. Now, if you need a variation, figure four on your back is a great place to go. I'd love it for you to call me over so I can demo figure four for you. But you can always hit me after this class and I'll be happy to help. Keep the toes on your left foot flexed. Continue to breathe deeply into your left hip. With your next inhale, start to make your way back. Hands underneath your shoulders. Curl your right toes under. Send your left leg high. Maybe open the hip. Maybe flip or get wild. Good. And then you'll meet me back in downward facing dog. Drop your knees. Swivel around to a seat. We'll take a forward fold. Soft bend to your knees. You can always extend
it's
them later.
To pause.
Inhale, arms
my
up.
My country's coming apart.
Exhale, fold.
The whole thing's becoming such a bumbling farce. Was that a pivotal historical moment we just went stumbling past? Well, here we are, dancing in the rumbling dark. So come a little
like
closer.
A wave crashing or waves crashing on a
give
beach.
Give me your beautiful, crumbling heart.
Each breath.
Another disaster, catharsis, another half-discarded mirage, another mask slips.
Good. Inhale, walk yourself
I face
back
off
in.
With the physical.
Scoot your hips
my
forward and lower down on your back.
The stars.
Hug both
there
knees into your stomach
here.
To reset and then extend your left leg long. Deep breath in, fill up, squeeze in, and then exhale. Roll your right knee over to the left.
Feeling really isn't us. Like we're gonna buckle underneath the trouble. Like any minute now, the struggle's gonna finish us.
Shift your gaze opposite.
And smile. That's all
back to the right. Soften your
it's hard.
Right shoulder blade down.
We've got our heads down and our hackles up. Our backs against the wall. I can feel you aching. None of this was
good. Inhale,
to
slowly
stop.
Come back. Inhale, breath to center. Squeeze in again. Reset. And then keep
even
your left knee.
Weak,
send your right leg long. Anchor
weak,
your right heel down.
Station,
breath in.
I can see
and
your
then roll
faces.
To the right.
There is so much peace to be found.
Shift your gaze back
faces.
To the left.
I saw it roaring. I felt it clawing at my
center,
clothes like a grieving
in.
Friend. It said there are no
one
new
final
beginning.
Squeeze and we'll release
everybody
into
sees
your final
that the old
Shabbat.
Ways need to end. but it's hard to accept that we're all one and the same flesh, given the rampant divisions between oppressor and oppressed. But we are, though. More empathy, less greed, more respect. All I've got to say has already been said. I mean, you heard it from yourself when you were lying in your bed and couldn't sleep, thinking, couldn't we be doing this differently?
See if you can tune in.
Listening to every little whisper in the distance singing hymns. And I can. I can feel things changing.
As it pulls your soft so tissue hard. Away from
your
bones.
We got our heads down and our hackles up, our backs against the wall. I can feel your heart racing. None of this was written in stone. The current's fast, but the river moves slow. And I can feel things changing. Even when I'm weak and I'm breaking, I stand weeping at the train station. Cause I can see your faces. There is so much peace to be found in people's faces.
And soften back. Your tongue melts away from the roof of your mouth.
It's not enough to imagine we'll be happy when we've got enough stuff. All this stuff is blocking us. I'm neat with no chaser. I'm all spirit, but I'm sinking. Because these days are not days, but strange symptoms. And this age is our age. But our age is rage sinking to beige. And yes, our children are brave. But their mission is vague. Now, I don't have the answers. But there are still things to say. I stare out at my city on another difficult day. And I scream inwardly, when will this change?
Take your
I'm beginning to fade, but my sanity's saved, because I can see your faces. My sanity's saved, because I can see your faces. It's hard. We got our heads down and our hackles up, our backs against the wall. I can feel your heart racing. None of this was written in stone. The current's fast, but the river moves slow. And I can feel things changing. Even when I'm weak and I'm breaking, I stand weeping at the train station. Cause I can see your faces. I love people's faces.
Now, if you have more time, stay as long as you like. If you are ready to get moving forward with your day, I'll guide you out. First, start to take back control of your breath. Deepen an inhale and match it with the exhale. Maybe start to wiggle your extremities, fingers and toes, wrists and ankles. I like a full body stretch, arms overhead, legs out long, but don't only reach with your toes. Play around with reaching with your heels sometimes as well. A little bit different activation in your pelvis that you don't want to lose sight of. Good, bring your arms in, roll to whichever side feels right, into a fetal position where you take a moment of gratitude for your practice, for your journey, for the community that supports you, whether there are stay-at-home orders or not. With an inhale breath, press yourself back up to a comfortable seat, facing front, palms at heart center. Such a pleasure to lead you today, Omis. Thank you so much for showing up on your mat, sharing your energy with class, with the universe, and most importantly, for showing up in your life every day. Inhale your thumbs to third eye center. The love in me honors and acknowledges the love within each of you. Namaste.
Nice work, y'all. So much fun. Feel free to hit me up afterwards. Love to hear your feedback to see how this went for you. If you've got requests, like the governor said, I'll be back. Love you. Be well.